Hello everyone, I'm going to start on the second layer of my resin and acrylic pour that I combined. And I want to give it a clear coat because I want to seal the acrylic pour. And I don't know if you can see it already, but I also added some very nice supercharged glitter in the turquoise and silver color and mix them together. It's on the edge of the acrylic pour. And I also added some real crystal, the Amazonite and the lapis lazuli. I like them very much. So also in some places those crystals. I already started with adding the clear on top of the two canvases. And now I'm heating it a little bit to make it more liquid, so that it can flow to the sides. And now on top of my supercharged glitter, I'm pouring a line of clear resin, so that they will stay where I want them. Also next to the glitter, but I'm not pouring on top of those very nice crystals. I don't want to have a lot of resin on top of them. I don't like that. So I'm pouring next to it, so that the resin will flow under the crystals. Now I'm pushing the resin against the stones, and also against the glitter. Such nice glitter is this. It's very large parts, but I like that. Gives a nice structure. And they sparkle a lot. Yeah, and the acrylic pour dried very well. It's totally dry, that's why I'm going to add this resin layer. Again, some clear on top of the glitter. All the materials I'm using are listed in this video, so the links to where you can buy the supercharged glitter, and also where you can buy the lapis lazuli and amazonite crystals, they are in the description box. So if you want to see where I buy my materials, then you need to check out the description box. More clear. Now I'm using my silicone spatula to move the resin around, to spread it over my two canvases, to the sides, because I need to cover it all. Yeah, and I'm very pleased how this turned out. It was an experiment. But I like to do that. And this was also nice to do some acrylic pouring again, because when I started with the acrylic, and then I saw some videos of resin from Anna-Marie Ridderhof, and yeah, I was amazed by the beauty of it, so I wanted to try it also. But to combine these two types of art, I like that. And I will do that more often in the future. And maybe some other things that I can add to make it a little bit more interesting. And also to challenge myself. Also at the end of this video, an close-up of the resin pour and the acrylic pour, and also up close the glitter and the crystals. So if you want to see that, then you can wait for it. But first I need to finish the clear coat. Little bit of heat so that it can flow to the sides. And also to remove some of the air bubbles that I have. Now I'm adding some resin with my stirring stick on some places. Because I look at it in all directions. And then I can see in the reflection of the light where it misses some resin, so that's why I'm adding it with my stirring stick. Yeah, and the rose gold glitter that I added in the first layer on top of the black is very nice. It's very sparkly. Such a nice glitter. It's a very fine rose gold glitter. Also working on the sides, that I have enough resin on the sides, on the edges. Again, some heat. Adding a little bit more resin to the sides so that it also flows over the side. Again, I'm looking at it in all directions, working a little bit on the sides now by adding it with my stirring stick onto the sides. There you can see it. Looking at it again. Making sure that the resin covers the sides. Now the torch for the air bubbles. And I do this several times, also during a drying process, at least the first hour. Adding a little bit more resin on the corners and on the sides, and then I'm done with this clear coat, and we can go to the close-up. So this is how it looks after 24 hours of drying, and it sparkles a lot. And I'm very pleased with the supercharged glitter, and also that sparkles a lot because on one side it has a mirror and on the other side it has a color. And also the fine glitter I added in the first layer on the black, very nice. And I'm very pleased how these two paintings look. It is a diptych, but you can also hang it separate. So a little bit closer. There you can see the acrylic pour I did. Very nice. Colors have blended nicely. And there you can see the lapis lazuli crystals. With the glitter line I've added against the acrylic pour. Also the nice flow in the acrylic pour, that I like that a lot. I'm not always after cells or whatsoever. I also like these effects. And there you can see the amazonite crystals against the glitter. Also the iridescent silver in the acrylic is sparkling a lot. I have some cells there in the corner. It's nice. Also that part I like a lot with the stripes. Gives a nice flow to the painting. Now to the resin pour. With the lacing I did, with the sparkly background that is shining through the cells. Very nice, very bright colors of color art. Also there's some nice knit lacing. Yeah, to combine resin and acrylic, I like it a lot. And also the texture I've given it is also very nice. There you can see the crystals. And also there's some cells. Yeah, there are some parts that I'm not totally satisfied with. Of the clear coat, so I need to let it dry and then take a look at it again and then decide what I'm going to do. But overall, it's a very nice painting. There are also some nice effects in the acrylic pour. There are the lapis lazuli crystals and the glitter up close. Yeah, and the green in it is a nice contrast with the rest of the colors. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up for this video if you like it. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. Those two links are in the description box. And also where I buy my materials, you can find in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!